Welcome to Warsaw. Believe me or not, but we are in the middle of the city that has over 2 million inhabitants. As many cities, Warsaw, here we have our river. It is called Wisła, the Vistula, and now you can see it just behind me. Warsaw is divided into two areas. The main one, the city center, you will find it on the western riverbank. And most of the people go there because this is where you're going to find places like the UNESCO World Heritage, the Old Town. But there is another Warsaw, the eastern bank. We call it Praga. Praga is a remarkable place full of very unique flavors and honestly very interesting history, and it is also full of the Jewish heritage. So, well, my name is Agnieszka, I'm a local guide and I am taking you for a walk. Student house for Jewish kids who wanted to study in Warsaw. Well, the building, the one you can see behind me, it was opened to the public in 1920s. The place was renowned for its very busy, very active and very hectic life. The upper floors of the building you can see behind me, they were reserved for the painters, so for the artists, future artists. But one of the most famous students who used to live here, Menachem Begin, then after Prime Minister of Israel and the winner of Nobel Prize for Peace, he studied law. The place was renowned for a very busy social schedule and actually a very crazy parties. The very center of Jewish neighborhood of Praga district. 60, 70 years ago, there would be a huge round building just behind me. That was the famous round synagogue of Praga district, the center of the community. What you can see today is another white building, but not a round one just behind me. It is the children institution or children facility of the Jewish community of Praga. It was built before the First War, not just an orphanage or not just a preschool. It was also a sort of a daycare. Back then, Praga was also an industrial part of the city. People were working long hours, 10, 11. So they needed a preschool or daycare for their children. That's why that building was so important. Right after World War II, it was the first venue of the Jewish Theater of Warsaw. One of the nicest monuments here. This is the Prague Band. Well, they used to be the main source of entertainment for the quarters, like the one we can still visit here in Praga district. Now, among many songs they used to play just to provide entertainment for people in the times like before TV sets or radios. So among many songs they used to play, there were also the tangos. Now, if you go to the core exhibition of our museum, the Poly Museum, then you'll see that there is a whole section dedicated to Polish Jewish music of 1920s and 1930s and to the story of the Jewish, tangos. Why? Because of the violin. People who are into music say that it is actually thanks to the Jewish musicians and thanks to the fact that they really like the sounds of violin that the Polish Jewish tangos were created. And there were two versions of it. Like the Polish version of a tango was called Ta Ostatnia Niedziela, the last Sunday we meet. But there was also a Hebrew version of it, the last Shabbat. The song, the music was the same. Love, longing for people you love, but the titles were different. What you can see behind me is one of the beautiful tenement houses from the 19th and 20th century. But, well, I remember it 20 years ago and it wasn't so. Now, Praga was not destroyed so much during World War II, but what happened here, it was much more a destruction wanted and undertaken by the communist authorities. They hated that beautiful decoration you can see behind me and they were destroying it, so the buildings were just the bricks, like the one this side. just look at the balcony over there. It looks like Italy, right? But right now we are visiting one of the most scenic and one of the most beautiful of courtyards of Praga district. All that place is called the old Róża Kwiatkowska tenement house, and it was built in 19th century. The beautiful balcony you can see, well, it was revitalized 20 years ago, but right now you can have that unique feel, vibe, how people used to live here, not just next doors, but basically sharing one large balcony. And as we go up to see the view from the balcony, just look around here. I've told you, Praga is the place of contrast. Just look at the cars. Well, the melting pot of culture, it is not just something of the past. Now, you are not here with me, but just believe me, there is just a remarkable smell coming from that Vietnamese bar just next doors. Well, a century ago, of course, there were no Vietnamese bar here, but the whole yard was full of smell of freshly cooked dinners, of haukas, of fish, of milk. There were also a lot of noises of people working here. In those inner yards, people were establishing the whole businesses, small factories, small workshops, people going to the market, kids going to school, neighbors arguing with neighbors. All those yards, they were like a small universe close within the walls of the neighboring houses. Everyday life in the Praga courtyard. Well, here we go. At the very center, we have beater. People used to beat their carpets here just to clean them. Right behind it, you can see a local shrine. It is, of course, a Roman Catholic shrine dedicated to our Virgin Maria. But there is also a very interesting place I'm going to show you just next to it. And you'll see that people were really living here, one next to another. If you get to know it a bit better and see it a bit closer, you see that not everyone here was actually Roman Catholic. Now, if you look up, or actually if you scratch the surface of the door frame, then you'll see that there are traces of mezuzah, and that means that Jewish community used to live here before World War II. Well, Connoisseur Center, just look around you, fancy restaurant, even more interesting bar on top of that panoramic deck. Right behind me, you can see Google Campus that we have here in Praga district. But can you imagine that even 20 years ago, it was one large vodka factory? I'm not joking. Vodka has been produced here since 19th century. But what's interesting, although that industrial way of producing vodka, this is something that has like what, over 100, 200 years history, the local traditions into consuming very heavy liquors, it goes back centuries and centuries. Very first, and actually one of the best, vodkas that you could try like 300 or 400 years ago, well, you'd have to go to a local inn, and vast majority of innkeepers from this period, they were actually Jewish people. And keeping an inn meant not just like organizing stuff, but actually producing local specialties like brewing beers or actually distilling vodka. Now, today, well, it is not just fancy looking spot for grabbing something to eat or something to drink. On this very side, few weeks back, we had one large Warsaw Festival of Jewish Culture, and every weekend you are going to find here also a local farmers market. This place is called Julian Różycki's Bazaar, or Bazar Życkiego, or simply Różyc. This is how we call it here in Warsaw. And officially, we are visiting the oldest marketplace in Warsaw. Officially, it was established in 1901, but truth to be told, people were actually trading here many years before that official establishing of the market. Now, as you can see, today the market is changing. Right behind me, you have the whole new section that is not even open yet. It's really brand new, so it's going to be way different in a few months. At the other side of the market, you can see the old section, so you can see the stalls, and there are still people selling and buying goods here. It wasn't so a century ago. Bazaar was sort of divided. There were sections, like areas that were specialized in something, like somewhere over there, there was a kosher section where the ladies were coming to buy kosher food. For my generation, it was much more place to come to get the jeans or Western CDs, because it was slightly illegal and black market area where people were selling their smuggled goods from the West. But there is another tradition, the tradition that we are going to explore some more in a few minutes. Tradition connected with food. Well, ladies used to cook pizza at home. They were like homemade dumplings and sell them straight here from the market. Today, well, you can get pizza in here, but today in the vicinity of Różyc, you are going to find a lot of nightlife, fancy bars, artistic places. And actually, that's also the idea behind the revitalization you can see behind me. But all the bars and arts and murals here, they are not the only art corner that we can explore here. Just wait and see. A little bit of Vienna, or perhaps even a little bit of Paris, and we are still in Praga, but in a completely different neighborhood. We are walking near Stalowa Steel Street, and this used to be a fancy part of Jewish Praga. Why the name? Stalowa means steel. Yeah, well, for years, Praga was known not just for its markets, but also for the industry. But today, well, you are not going to find a lot of factories because they were mostly destroyed during World War II. Różyc market, it wasn't the only market in Praga district. Right here, and we are near Stalowa Steel Street, there was another market site. Of course, today you won't see it. It was closed like 50 years ago. And today we have from one hand side a fancy building, and from other hand side, well, there's still piece of local history. The reason why I wanted to take you here, it is because I'm going to show you quite unique piece of art. One of the newest murals of the city, the one you are going to find here in Praga, it was painted by Hasme. And if you look it from here, then you probably think about abstract art. But then again, second look, and now you know, we are again in the middle of the market, although this time we are looking at it from above. Pizzy dumplings from the jar. Well, you can still have them here in Praga. We are really very, very close to the market. Well, basically it is one large dumpling and it is full of meat, and there is also meat gravy on top of it. And well, this is probably not the most elegant restaurant you are going to find in Warsaw, but believe me, there are people coming here for pizzy, even from across the river, Smacznego.